If you look at the screen, you can see the old UFO moving in the vast sky. The background isn't break, even if it moves away. In the case of a top-down airplane game, there will be many creators who find it difficult to implement this background. Today, I will show you how to do it simply and easily. These are the current scene settings. The camera is looking down on the player flight game object. There is a script named Manager Control that it allows you to move the game object. And the player flight has a 3D cube as a child so you can check it visually. Now, let's create the terrain that will be the background. Create a plane, one of the 3D objects. The player is flying in the sky, so I'm going to remove the mesh collider in the terrain. Then, apply the seamless texture prepared in advance. I left URL, where you can download the image in the description of the video. Check the wrap mode of the imported textures in repeat setting. We will use the materials offset. If you change the XY value of offset, it looks like scrolling. Now we figured out how the background looks moving, we need to implement it via script. Let's create a C# script named Manager Terrain Text and apply it to the terrain game object. To change the properties of the texture or shader, you need to access the renderer component. In this video, I will make the public renderer variable and bring the component directly. Next, let's write a test code to see how the texture offset works. First, create a float variable to use temporarily. Let's make the float variable I just created incremented by 0.01 per frame. Repositioning of the texture is worked by a function called main texture offset. Since the texture is 2D, we need to use the Vector2 variable. I will apply a float variable to the values of each X and Y. I forgot to register the renderer component to a variable. Let's run the game again. When you run the game, you can see the image of the terrain move smoothly. Now we need to implement the background texture to move accordingly when the player moves. I'm going to create a public transform variable so we can refer to the player's position. I will comment out the test code. The process is similar, however, I will change the X and Y values used in the Vector2 variable to the player's position. After registering the player game object in the transform variable, let's run the game. You can see the terrain texture also moves with the player's movement, but the speed is very fast. Let's add a float variable that can control the speed, and multiply it by the Vector2 variable. The speed is too slow, and the texture movement is the same as the player movement direction. I don't feel like the object is flying. I'm going to change the speed to -0.05. It looks much better than before. Now, let's make the terrain bigger. I will move the terrain object and camera to the lower hierarchy of the player. With a simple trick, we have been able to create endless backgrounds. Let's use this method to create a more three-dimensional background. Let's modify the terrain object to follow the player. This method is not required, but it is good to know. Detach the terrain game object from the player. I'm going to write a code that follows the terrain according to the player's position. There is a problem that even the Y position of the terrain becomes the same as the player. Create a float variable that will change the Y position of the terrain, and modify the code as follows. Don't forget to apply the Y value of Vector3 to the float variable height. Since the current terrain's Y position is 0, we will also set the height to 0. You can see the terrain game object's Y position stays at 0, and follows the player well. Now, let's make a more three-dimensional background which looks flat. Duplicate the terrain game object, and rename it Terrain Cloud. I have an alpha textured image with clouds on a transparent background. When using the standard shader, set the rendering mode to fade. Apply the material to the terrain cloud. Please raise the Y position of the terrain cloud game object slightly upwards. There is a three-dimensional feel of the background, but it is still not enough. Let's reduce the terrain's offset speed to give the feeling it is far from the player. It feels a lot more three-dimensional than before. That's all for today's video. Thank you, see you next time.